Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
Yeah.
Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
Yeah.
Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
That's
money,
right.
Money on my mind. So money is all I think of.
That's right.
Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
Bitch.
Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
Money,
you
know.
Money on my mind.
Bitch.
Money on my mind.
Bitch.
Money on my mind. So
ay.
Money is all I think of.
Yeah. Stepping at the motherfucking count, day and out. I'm looking like a star, bitch. When you see me make a wish, holla at your motherfucking ball, JR. Birdman, my paw, bitch. Ball, brat, born rich. Dear Mr. Toilet, I'm the shit. Got these other haters pissed, cause my toilet paper thick, I know. But tripping at 40, make a chip out of potato head wimp. Then like ranch, I dip. And the hustle was all muscle, just strength. When it comes to that weight, I don't struggle, I just live on two. I got my hand on the game, yeah, I make a grip. 100 grand in my fist, same on my wrist. Get key money from a quarter, blame it on my wrist. I whip coke like hoes, nigga, I'm a pimp. Lil nigga about to rape the market. If we talk about money, baby, now we talking.
Money on my mind,
yeah.
Money on my mind.
Fuck bitches.
It's a non-proc Nightblade build. I call it the Shadow Scale because of the Elder Scrolls lore. The Shadow Scale was the Dark Brotherhood assassin, and they were always Argonian. They were the best assassins that they had. Good at disappearing, reappearing, killing their enemies, etc. If you want to look up the lore, just Google it. Let's get right into the gear. Alright. Running the Maelstrom Maul. It's infused. Your ideal trait would be Sharpen. I have a Sharpen Greatsword actually. And that's great for this. As well as the axe. Any of the Maelstrom weapons sharpens would be ideal. For the bows, I have a normal defending bow. You can use a Maelstrom defending bow, but the ideal bow would be the master's defending bow. I'm running heavy armor, 5-piece heavy armor, but next patch I will be running medium armor due to the nerf of all of most product sets like Viper and Tremor Scale and all that good stuff. Medium armor still works. It's just the simple fact that if you get caught in a burst, you're gonna get shitted on. And that's my bolt to people. By one person, you'll be fine. One or two people, you'll be fine. It's just that when you start getting Zerg down, you'll get shitted on real quick. Alrighty. I got Shackle Breaker. My first set, Shackle Breaker's head, heavy, impen. All the pieces impen for Shackle Breaker. If they're heavy, just keep them impen. Shoulders, waist, hands, and feet. My second set, I have Cinch's Bite. Well fitted. Make sure these pieces are well fitted to mitigate the dodge roll. Chest, legs, rings, and necklace. You want your rings to be weapon damage and your necklace to be stam recovery. Alright, if you choose to do medium armor, you can do all weapon damage because your recovery will be around 2300. So that's more than enough. If you continue to do medium, make sure you have 4 pieces that are well fitted, including these two. So you have 1, 2, and make like your hands and waist or something well fitted if you make a medium. All right. That's it for the gear. I use normal poisons, damage poisons. Cause poisons are pretty cheesy, so I don't use them. For pots, my food is Dubious Cameron Throne. You can buy this fairly cheap or have somebody craft it for you if you don't have the recipe. And tri-stat pots. Tri-stat pots are ideal for this build because you are an Argonian. Can't say no more. You can go from 1k health to 15k with one tripod. I'm just saying, because of the passes. All right, let's get into the skills. For heavy armor, I'm running Expert Hunter. I switch it out. When I'm in medium armor, I put Executioner, Killer's Blade, because I have trouble executing people. I can get them low, but once it's time to execute, I have trouble. Masteria, CC, Rally, your Major Brutality, and your Heal. Surprise Attack is going to be your main spammable. Ambush is your Gap Closer, and your Empower. And of course, the Holy Godly Incap. Pretty sure it's the best all in the game, but we ain't gonna talk about that. Incap, you can ambush Incap if you desire with this build. You can still gank with this build. You can open world with this build, 1vx with this build. You can do a lot with this build, all right? Even in duels, you can duel with this build as well. But I usually don't ambush Incap, and when I do, it's only when there's a lot of people on me and I'm trying to get people off of me as fast as possible. So I dodge roll, ambush, Incap. But you'll see that I'll explain the gameplay in the footage. Back bar, I run a Shadow Image, Vigor, Mirage, Poison Inject, Siphoning Attacks, and Soul Tether. I run Shadow Image because I'm in heavy armor. What do I need cloak for? and it's a lot of fun to play with. Like when you're getting Zerg down, you run, you turn around, place the Shadow Image on a Zerg, jump off a cliff and watch them jump behind you, and then hit Shadow Image and teleport back up. And it's funny. It's a lot of fun. Trust me, it's a lot of fun. Mirage, it's my personal preference for the minor resolve. Shuffle is good because it removes all the snares off of you, but with my experience with Mirage, I feel like I dodge a lot more. They're both 15% chance, that's what it says, but I feel like I dodge a lot more. It's my personal preference. If you want to use Shuffle, use it. Siphoning Attacks, all right. The reason I don't have, people are probably like, why don't you have Relentless Focus? You're stupid. Okay, this is a heavy armor build. I'm an Argonian. I gotta play to the strengths of my Argonian, which is healing. And with Siphoning Attacks on my bar and Soul Tether on my bar, I get this passive. Increase my healing done by 3% for each Siphoning ability slotted. Alright. 6% with my Argonian passives is going to be 11%. Now I can put 4 more percent to push it up in my champion points to push it up to 15%. So that's the reason I have it, especially on heavy armor. You can get a lot of heals out of this. But when I'm running medium armor, I throw, you know, good old Relentless over there. But right now, I don't run it. All right, let's look at the stats. Unbuffed. 2300 weapon damage, 21 stamina recovery, 2100 stamina recovery, 42 weapon crit, crit resistance 2200, 15,000 for the resistances, for the spell and physical resistances, max stamina 32.4, health and Cyrodiil would be around 22.6. Yeah, max magic is 12.22. So you can use, if you want to use cloak, you can use cloak a lot on this build, man. A lot. All right. You can cloak probably as much as a magic nightblade. I'm not even kidding. But I don't use it, as I said. Let me buff up. All right. I'm at 33.14. And just with the right, I'm at 27, so 33.14, 48 crit, weapon crit. All right, in medium armor, you'll go up to your weapon damage with the dodge roll will be around 3900, somewhere around there, and your stamina recovery if you're using Silver Stone will be up around 2400. But then again, like I said, when you're in medium armor, you can drop your recovery to 22. And put a damage, weapon damage glyph on here, and you'll be well over 4k. for damage, and you'll be destroying guys. That's how I'm gonna be playing next patch, as a matter of fact. Let's get right into the channel points. I'll redo all my channel points for you guys, actually. So we can start in the green tree. This is how I start. I usually put your dodge rolling a lot. You're also blocking, but I put 20% into here. And people are gonna be like, I'm crazy and all this stuff. You're playing against your strengths. Alright. Your heavy armor, you definitely need 43 or something in here, you know. 10%. I always put 12% in my recovery. Always. There it goes. And right here, I put about 38. 36, 38. Really, just all you need is 23. This is the magic touch right here. If you can make that thing hit as hard as possible, do it, baby. That's for your end cap. All right, blue tree. Put around 4% in there, 15. And master at arms, you need to put points into this. So 56, around 56. Then I go to mighty. Put around 50. I put 56 as well in mighty. Weapon, physical weapon expert. Throw 25 in there. Precise strikes. I throw 10% in there. $2,000 in there, and then the rest, shattering blows on my beautiful swords. All right, in here we got ironclad. Off rip, I put 56 in ironclad because that mitigation is way better than elemental and defender and hardy. But I put 43 to both of these for the 10% mitigation. All right, then I put the rest until I get to the unchained passive. It's about 38, I believe, 35, 34. All right, and the last 34, I throw a bit of resistance. There you go, that's the champion point setup. All right, I go through them one more time, 15 blessed, 25, 56, and 13, 23, 22, and 56. 56 and 34, 34, 43 on both, and nothing in this tree. 23, 56, 43, 32, and 56. There you go. Enjoy the footage. I have commentary all throughout it. Subscribe, like, and comment. Tell me what you think I'm doing wrong. Because there's always somebody. All right, guys. Have a good one.
Here's a clip of me dueling with the build. I'm wearing heavy armor. Hollow duel 50 times a day, at least. So we know each other's techniques and stuff, so we have to switch it up all the time. I'm going on defensive because I usually don't. Especially with this build, this is a counter build. But you're gonna see them cap him into the counter cap. That's how you wanna play with the build. You wanna counter. Block my in cap and it came back and in cap. As you can see, the only time I take out the pressure is the buff. I go right back into the buff. I don't wait on the merciless combo. Go after it. See, I dodged his merciless to come back. I usually would have hit him with an in-cap right there, but I saved it. I'm about to die. There you go. Go right into it and execute.
Hollywood cold.
In a time you were fine, can't walk without him, can't talk without him, can't breathe without him, came here together, you can't leave without him, so you walk back in, make a scene about him, on your Amarie, it's just one thing about him, it's called out, you just don't sing about it no more, don't nobody sing about it no more, no more, it's called out, niggas don't sing about it no more, don't nobody sing about it no more,
to the window, to the window.
Got all the bitches in the club singing.